Julia Roberts. Denzel Washington in John Grisham's The Pelican Brief. We find out more in a minute. Coming soon to Sky Movies, The Pelican Brief. It began with two justices of the United States Supreme Court murdered on the same night. And a paper by a law student that told far more of the truth than she realized. Getting its TV premiere on October the 7th, The Pelican Brief stars Julia Roberts.
You know, my girlfriend, this girl, she wrote a very interesting essay on who might have ordered the assassination. This is a little bit left field.
Your girlfriend has a theory?
Here, you ought to take a look at it. You get a kick out of the way her mind works.
What his girlfriend inadvertently uncovers...
Miss Shaw!
...is more than just theory.
You take my breath away.
The shocking truth goes to the highest levels of government and could cost her her life. The Pelican Brief is based on John Grisham's best-selling novel and is directed by Alan J. Pakula, who made those classic thrillers Clute and All the President's Men. As well as Julia Roberts, it stars Denzel Washington. And joining them, Sam Shepard, Tony Goldwyn, Robert Culp, and John Lithgow.
I've always been interested in the Washington scene, you know, long before All the President's Men, and having a chance to deal with the Washington establishment gave me great pleasure. I love doing suspense films. There is a great pleasure in hearing an audience shriek.
He loves to scare people. He does, and he says it with sort of, you know, pride and wonderment. He loves to, you know, take you to the very edge. And then make you feel safe as a kitten and then just scare the wits out of you.
Author John Grisham had Julia Roberts in mind when he created Darby Shore. And after she read the screenplay written by director Alan J. Pakula, she was eager to bring the character to life.
I think that I've sort of grown up a lot, or just have different sort of ideas of what's important. And so I think it was the adultness of her that originally I thought was interesting.
Well, how does it implicate the White House? What are the names?
One name.
Someone we both know.
The reception given Darby's brief is something she could never have imagined. But she soon discovers the reality that there is danger all around her. Running becomes second nature for her, until even that becomes too dangerous.
Is this Greg Grantham with the Washington Herald?
Yes, it is. Who's this?
She believes that there's safety in the power of the press. And she turns to someone she thinks she can trust. And now, two lives are on the line.
I would like to think it doesn't usually get to this extent, this extreme. But I think he realizes people in Washington, or anywhere for that matter, these days, are capable of doing anything to, you know, when greed is involved, power, and most importantly, money.
They become bound by the fact that the more he gets brought into it, the more danger he's in. So they're both sort of in this great peril. And that really binds two people together.
The world Darby used to inhabit was quiet and orderly, framed by her studies and the law. Now it's been overtaken by a world of chaos and darkness, where she has to defend herself against people for whom the taste of power is sweeter than life itself.
They don't take the Pelican Brief seriously at all to begin with. It's just a potential political mess, because her theory is very far-fetched of who assassinated these Supreme Court justices, and unfortunately it turns out to be true.
He's afraid that it might be damaging to the president.
How's that?
It's all there in the brief.
The ultimate paranoia. Being exposed to the ultimate nightmare, that you don't know whom you can trust anymore. And that web of paranoia and people that she sees on the street and that whom she tries to look in their eyes and not knowing is sensational storytelling. It's the anticipation of something happening and the shock of something totally unexpected.
I think it's a very smart thriller. But it's very clever. I think that Alan has sort of spun a very clever, frightening web.
The Pelican Brief gets its first screening on Sky Movies in October. Coming up, we hear from Jeff Bridges, Isabella Rossellini, and Rosie Perez about life on the edge. We take a look at the movie Fearless in a minute. Coming soon to Sky Movies, Fearless. Fearless is an emotional drama from director Peter Weir, whose previous hits have included Picnic at Hanging Rock, Witness, and Dead Poets Society. It's the story of a man who survives a terrible plane crash and begins to feel that he is immortal. He is Jeff Bridges.
Well, I play a fella who is really quite afraid of flying. And the way he's gone about dealing with his fear is to really educate himself as much as he can about the plane, to find out which of the safest planes to fly, what airports you want to avoid, this sort of thing. And yet, in spite of all his knowledge, he finds himself on a plane that's going down. He ends up surviving the crash. And the film, from my character's point of view, is how it affects him and his family and people that are dear to him.
I think that Laura has many, many, many feelings. At the beginning, probably, of incredible joy that her husband has survived, and then slowly discovering that she has lost him, as some other people have lost their loved ones, but she's lost him in a very unconcrete way. You know, he's there, physically there, he's at home, and yet he's not there.
What didn't you call? What were you?
I was visiting my past.
But why didn't you tell me you were alive?
I thought I was dead.
But also there is the love, there is also the compassion, there is also the tremendous feeling of compassion, for example, for the character of Rosie Perez, and jealousy, because the husband is so involved with Rosie Perez in a form of kind of a strange love.
Cars across the street, Super Drive.
No, I can't. The doctor told me I can't go
nowhere. You'll be safe. You read the papers. Everybody with me live.
What are you telling me? There's no God, but there's you?
Come with me. Carl, I promise you'll be safe.
I think Carla believes what the Catholic religion told her to believe, but yet she kind of passed through death. So now she's not only guilty about Bubble, but she's also guilty about questioning the rules of the church, of what it's supposed to all be about. You know, that it's really not about the rules, it's all about spirituality. You know, she saw it, and it kind of scared her, and she was compelled to stand in front of God, but at the same time, she was fearful to look him in the face because she got so close, you know? It was weird. I don't know. That was my interpretation of it, of Carla. For Max, that's a whole different story.
I
want
to know about this film.
Carla.
Mm. Why did you introduce him? What were you trying to achieve?
Well, no one can reach her. If she doesn't get help, she'll end up in an institution, or worse.
And her husband?
It worries me.
Why?
I don't know. I think he thinks he's invulnerable.
I felt when I read that script, I thought it was so unique, you know, that I had never seen anything like this before, and that's how I make my choices. One of the ways is I think, you know, is this a film that I'd like to see? And I thought if I could pull this off, I'd love to see a movie like this.
Get out of the road! can't do it! You want to kill me, but you can't!
Fearless on Sky Movies in October.